third five. And then we guessed that the triangle formed by these three points is the right cross-sectional triangle. We just guessed that this is so. Now I want you to prove as a hint. Maybe you can find segments in this figure which are perpendicular and equal. Find two segments that are perpendicular and equal. These two segments, the sides of the triangle, are such, but we don't know. And I want you to find the segments about which you can prove that they are such. Okay?
Excuse me. Yes. Are you taking an arbitrary point?
Yes. Well, this?
No.
No, this I said, this is midpoint. About these two segments. Remember the problem of the two triangles. And there were two segments that were congruent and made 60 degrees. So here it is similar. Remember why they were congruent and made 60 degrees. Of course, in this figure there are many segments that satisfy these two conditions. Two sides of each square, many people, and this two sides, this two sides, this two sides, so on. But of course, this is not what I mean. Actually, we have a problem about the two segments that I'm talking about. They are this one and this one. Why are they congruent? Why are they perpendicular? Can you recall the solution or find it again? How do we prove that these two green segments are congruent and perpendicular? Now, how do we use the segments to prove this statement? Congruent is the same as equal. In mathematics, the word equal has too many meanings. Two figures are equal because they have the wrong side. Yes, and they are here. Therefore, there is a special word for figures that can be coincident. So, have you recalled why about the fact about this two green segments? Here the squares are constructed externally on mid-floor, but we also can, so if you imagine that I take this point and drag it down below the side, this is the principle. This one and this one. So, but maybe this figure is a bit more simple than that one. How to prove the theorem about the triangle using the green section? That's the question. Yes. We can do this. So, okay, first of all, let me remind you that how do we prove that the green segments are perpendicular and congruent? Maybe I will even use this notation. For congruence, actually, in geometry, we often use this notation. But this means that the figures are congruent. For the segments, the same way. So, what I can do is, I can take this center and rotate about the center by 90 degrees. And then this point goes here. And this point goes here. And that's it. We have. Remember? And if you go here to this figure, take the same center and rotate 90 degrees. And this point. So let this be A, B, C, D, E, F, G. So where does B go under this rotation? Where does point B go under this rotation?
To point D.
To point?
D.
D? No. 90 degree rotation.
To point E?
To point E, yes. This is rotation, right? So this goes to E. And F goes to
C.
So this segment goes to this. Therefore they are congruent and perpendicular, right? Understand? Okay. So, okay, let's return to this view. So we know about this sector that they are congruent and perpendicular. And I want to prove the same for the blue segment. Can I use the green segment for the blue segment? You will be surprised how easy it is. Use your imagination.
This is an arbitrary triangle.
Oh.
Any triangle. No, you don't know anything about it.
It can be this, it can be that. No. We can reduce the problem to a regular triangle if it is a fine problem, if it's a thin dimension. I think I should help. I want to draw this segment. Then I have. What do I have? So, now look at this segment and this one. What can you say about it?
Yes.
And the same with the same here. If we take this
here,
then this is the midline of the triangle CBE.